Jacob and Monisha will be responding me, keeping your mic on. Okay, no, because the Mary and Jacob mic is on, so that you can respond me. Yes, sir, you can move to the next slide. So what the name appeared to me, just I have taken the name, now sharing the screen. It visible?
Yes, sir.
Marin, fine. I am also guessing that some more Shy Nikita. Shy Nikita joined the class. Nikita Ishwarna, Shy Nikita, Monisha, you have joined the class.
Sir.
Fine. That you were keeping your mouth on, and I will be asking more questions to you. Take care. So now, so first, today's we have kept the mainly functions, but before that, importing modules in Python, how we are importing the modules. And if you want to import some sub module also, you can say that what will be the syntax to importing sub modules. And then we will start this function and this def statement, parameters, return values. And additionally, I should say one more, this keyword and default arguments, what we are calling in that other programming language, that actual argument and formal argument. So that will be also here, the keyword and default argument. So now that importing modules, yes, it is having the rich set of library. I'm always telling that it is having the powerful libraries. So each module is a Python program that contains a related group of functions that can be embedded in your program. So suppose when you are requiring some of the math functions, scientific functions, and so that at that time you are writing math, import math, and from math module, that what are the built-in functions with the math module, you can use that. So each module is a Python program that contains a related group of functions that can be embedded in your program. For example, the math module has mathematics related functions. The random module has random number related functions. So before you can use this function, no, first you will have to import that particular module. And the statement to import the module is import. You can say that the keyword to import the module is import. And one module if you want, then submodule, the another syntax is there, but several modules at a time, some different modules. Like that, you can say that import random, comma, math, comma, sys, comma, OS. Like that, separate modules can be imported by one import statement. So first import keyword, and optionally more module names as long as they are separated by comma. How many modules you want to import by one import, you can give that. I have given some example here for I in range 5. So, and random modules I have imported. I want to print the random integers. And you know that the random integers, it is not like that the default random integer, a random function will give that any value from 0 to 1. Even we can say here, no, I want the integer value and any integer value from 1 to 10. But when you are giving the range in rand integer, the range should not be in the reverse way. So I want a random integer value from 10 to 1, not in this way. That way I have checked, it will give the error. So random integer from range, you can give any of the number, any of the integer between the given range, you will find. So output, what to describe the output here, Marin Jacob? How many times it will display random and what numbers it will be displaying? I have written the output question mark. Marin, you only. to get the full marks of the day-to-day activities. Now, Marin is not answering. And Monisha?
Yes, sir.
Who is answering?
Monisha.
Monisha, the session is being recorded, no? So that your voice and your answer will be recorded. Priscilla, if your mic is not working, then you can write the answer also in the chat box. So you are making this session live and your participation is also recorded. And if participation is recorded, you are getting few marks for the day-to-day work activities, participation in the class. Okay, Monisha. First, for I in range 5, print random dot rand int. Rand int, I have given the significance, any number from 1 to 10. So how many times it will print random numbers?
5 times, sir.
You
so 5 times, any
right.
Number between
5 to 10. Talk to your USN report, that also will be recorded, no? Last 3 digit of USN. Because I am not...
So 076. Yes.
Again. 096. 096. Name? You can say
sure.
096. My name is XYZ. I am taking that question. It is displaying this one. That much only in 3-4 seconds. One boy student sound I have heard. The Mehul or Manpreet?
Mehul, sir. 99.
Okay. Good. Again, tell me Mehul.
It will be printed 5 times.
Any random number from 1 to 10, it will be printed.
Any 5.
Okay. That you know that this important significance of the SIS module. So SIS module helps you that if you have imported no any time to terminate the program, it is not equivalent to break. Exit a statement you have used in C programming also. Here sys.exit. Directly you can write. And finally it will terminate that program. And finally you typed exit or what you find EXIT, so it is responding. So I will move to the next slide. Monisha, I will move to next slide.
Yes, sir.
Fine. So function, that basic like kids, a function is a method used to perform some task. You know that now you have started to say the function method. Then you are writing the classes. At that time you are telling, have you written your method? Yes, sir, I am writing the method. So function is a method used to perform some tasks. Name is followed by pair of parentheses. May a function may or may not have arguments, parameters. The another line, if a function may or may not return any value, a parameter is a variable that an argument is stored in when a function is called. Arguments or parameters are separated by comma. Why function? So it is modular approach. It is subdividing a program into meaningful segments. And this way it will be easy to debug and it will reduce the complexity of the program. Major purpose also is there that a function is to be get called within a loop several times. So we can write a loop and the function call can be written in the loop. So these are the functions basic you have already done. I am giving here that to define how to define a function with the def keyword directly example is written, the name of the function. And within the parenthesis, you are writing the argument. So def hello name, print hello name. So hello Rubia, so it will display hello Rubia. Hello Sultan, it will display the hello Sultan. I have taken one question from the book, textbook. And that is also you can guess from the VTU exam. If they are conducting online or offline. So what will be the output of this program? It is the question of your textbook. So program is like that, take any random number from 1 to 9, any random number. And here not to confuse that it is any range, sir. So if it is range, it will be giving 1 before 9, no? No, no, it is rand int, you are giving the range. So rand int is 1 to 9, and you can write your prediction, your magic num, like you are showing the card. So randomly, if the computer will display, or in the lottery system. So who will win that online lottery? Because the randomly I am getting one number, and whose number will come? That students will be asked questions. That roll number will be asked questions, or that particular number has to go on, or for all the things that if it is a magic telling some future predictions, so that I have given. And this way you are getting that also one get answer and answer number. Here you see that last, I am calling that storing the value of calling the random dot rand into 19. So any number you have taken, and then the fortune equal to get answer and print fortune. So that if random number is 5, so what answer will be displayed? Ask again later. If it is 2, it is decidedly so. It is certain. It is 4. If it is 4, then reply as try again. Like that. Some in the book it is given. Concentrate and ask again. Like that. So if elif is also displayed, you can take a random number and display your future by your program or prediction about anything. Whether it is going to be done, doubtful, not so good, reply is no, exactly you are getting, like that. I will move to the next slide.
Yes, sir.
Fine. One extra thing is here, that in Python, one new keyword, you have learned that none value. Better to say the keyword I am telling that is none value. So sometimes some value is not stored in a variable. How we can check that? So this none value represents the absence of a value. In other programming language, we are calling it null, nil, like that, or undefined. So here none type data type. None is only value. It is the none type data type. So interview question also that what is the type of none value? So none type. So see that I have written here spam equal to print hello. So what will be stored in spam? It is printing hello. That doesn't mean that hello value is stored in spam. You have written spam equal to print hello, and not like that some string variable, some integer variable you have given in the C programming in the interview. And it is given here that how to print 1 to 10 without using any loop or without like that main you are calling, or sometimes like that if you are writing total equal to printf Dr. P.N. Singh, you have given some string and you are writing total equal to. So actually what will be the length of the string? No, that total length will be stored in that integer value. Here it is not like that spam equal to print hello. Nothing is stored in spam. When you are printing a spam, variable is correct, no value is there. Then I am telling, okay, print a spam, it is telling none, nothing in spam. So that again we are checking by that this boolean double equal to sign, spam double equal to none. Yes, it is telling true. No value is stored for spam. So this value without a value, what it act? What does this function? What is a void? So void is a return type that doesn't return any value. Void is a return type used with function that doesn't return a value. So value without a value. Here I can just to encourage, because I think in fifth semester Unix is there going on. Anyone please respond.
Yes, sir.
Unix is going on. Okay. Yes, so that I will take 2 minutes. That one Unix question was there when the developer was developing the Unix. No, so echo command to echo command, so echo something to display something, echo. So the developer was funny that the three team members, the Dennis Ritchie himself and the Brian Kernighan. So Brian Kernighan was very having the very sense of humor. So he has written in that book of Unix that one of the developer was trying to develop a code for what? Echo nothing. So that yes, the system Unix has units, because any of the, when you are writing any programming language, no? So the programming language itself, the word is a feminine gender. For that, they are telling that I am telling her to echo nothing. So yes, nothing it is telling, okay. Means nothing was displayed, but it should at least open the mouth, no? It has to echo nothing, but it has to open the mouth and close the mouth. Means what? At least it should go to the next line of prompt. So for that, when the Unix has already done this, and that particular developer, the Brand Carnegie line, that he died on his spot by the surfeit of notation, that performance has been done by the program. So by heart attack or what, or it is might or it is joke, but the Brian Kernighan writing that by surfeit of notation, the developer died on the spot because the Unix has already done it. I mean to say, echo nothing. In which way will write in the Unix? No, echo nothing, nothing to say. So echo, and you are just starting some curly, double quotes and closing the double quotes and hitting the enter. It has to display nothing, but it must come to the next line of the prompt. So the question was, the problem was of developer. Yes, I have told to echo something. Okay, I have told to echo something that is nothing, but at least it should open its mouth and close it. So change it, change its prompt. For that reason, a value without a value. A value without a value can be helpful when you need to store something that won't be confused for a real value in a variable. In the previous program, you have seen that how to find the largest and the smallest. And earlier, what we were doing, that first number is assumed as maximum, and the rest of the numbers we are compared. And if any number is found greater than maximum, then that will be again replacing that so-called maximum. But here no need, the maximum and minimum, the largest and the smallest in the beginning can be defined as none. And you can compare if largest double equal to none or any number greater than largest, then largest equal to that number. So if any variable to be assigned without a value, what is without a value? That is none. So it is very nice. One place where none is used as the return value of the print. See that print function displays the text on the screen, but it doesn't need to return anything in the same way by the len or input days. Print function displays what you have written. But if you will say that what is returned by the print function, sir, what you have written in the print function, that will be displayed. But if you are storing that print function to another variable, nothing will be stored in that particular variable. Should I go to the next slide? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. So here, my famous program, what I have taught, but it is already given here, that when you are writing a string, the built-in slicing the string, it is there, a string, underscore bracket, colon, colon, minus one will reverse the string. But the question of the university is, you will have to write your function in Python to check whether a string is palindrome or not. It is built-in function already there, but you will have to write a function to check a string whether it is palindrome or not. The logic, 20 of the students, I have taught the two times in the first year, second time, so that we are taking, finding the length of the string first. Then we are running the loop from first letter to half of the string. Getting my point? The first is compared with the last. The second will be compared with the second last. The third will be compared with the third last. And this way, this comparing will continue to the half of the string. So here again, one confusion should not come to the programmer. If it is a nine letter string, so what is the half of the string? There will not be index number in fractional value, no? You cannot say that 4.5th character. So either you compare four or five, the index number will not be in fraction. So here I am directly revising that particular definition. The loop will run from first character to half of the length, better to say here, integer value of the half of the length. If madam is compared, M is compared with M, A is compared with A, D you are comparing with D or not comparing. Why to compare the middleth value with the middleth value again? So that when it is having the length in odd number, 9, then also you compare up to 4. If it is having even number of characters, then also you compare up to 4. So for that reason, I have taken here len str by 2, I less than, not less than equal to, less than str by 2. So if length is 9 also, then it should be less than. So less than 4, okay. If str of I not equal to str of j, so there is no need to check it further. As that you have written manorama, so M is not matching with the A, so no need to check it and just return the false where it is called. Return a statement returning the control or value from where it is called. And I, the first character, the position, first is compared with the last and second is compared with the second last. So I is the first, J is the last. So I plus equal to 1, J minus equal to 1. So this all are written with the while. And finally, it is aligned, the return true. Means if it has not returned false up to yet, means all the characters from beginning to middle, and as you have compared with the logic, it is matching, then you are returning true. So I have written here input inter string. It is taking the value in the S and passing in the isPalin and calling here. And here I have used the 2-3 times. You see that double quotes what? So if any of the string is entered, no. So I want to display that particular string enclosed within double quotes. Suppose you are writing a sentence that is also a string. So that sentence will break the structure of the sentence. What you have checked, whether the string is palindrome or not, whether the string was also having the blank spaces, for that, what a string you have checked, that should also appear in the output. Just it is one discipline of that particular output, so that it will be user friendly. No, manorama is not a palindrome, and manorama is enclosed within double quotes. I want to print that manorama also in double quotes, means this particular string you have checked. Again, inter string madam, yes, madam is a palindrome. Inter string, you know that from first year, if I have shared that one of the sentence of Napoleon Bonaparte, that Abul was I air, I saw Elba, and it is not the platform, so that I can enjoy that for what situation he has used that particular sentence. Abul was I air, I saw Elba. The words here, not literature class, but only one. So that one word make out the problem. What is this ERE, sir? Err. The Jewish English err means not here. Abul was I err, ERE, I saw Elba. Means I was not able to do what? I was not able, or I was not knowing love when the Elba has proposed. So in the midnight, the Napoleon has written in his diary before his death, and that was diary was taken and the sentence was taken, and it is regarded as one of the sentence. I am not saying that it is the first sentence that is the palindrome, but it is regarded one of the first sentence that is a palindrome. Elva is the name of the girl. Here in this program, any of the thing, any of you, if you have not understood, you can pause me, sir, that particular thing I have not understood. Vani has joined. Vani, I don't know that your mic is on. Vidya? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Vidya, you are getting everything what I have written?
Yes, sir.
Any confusion, anything to explain again? So that particular while loop you have understood? Because
yes,
I'm asking you with the only that why I have used the comparing that data string starting from first to total number of string divided by 2. Why up to middle of the string only?
Because palindrome is that way, right, sir? Because
so that the another simple logic may be, you know, first you find the reverse of the string and then compare. If both are equal, then display yes, it is a palindrome. But you are giving here the another logic to reduce the complexity. So why to find the string, finding the reverse? Just compare up to half of the, because you are not using here the built-in function, built-in method. So you can take 1 minute with that to get the 2 days full marks. To describe that, take the 1 minute or 2 minutes. Logically, just explain the logic to check whether a string is palindrome or not. So I am just boosting you, all of you up. Any of you can unmute the mic and say that. First job is to find the length of the string, and we will compare the string first with last. So we will run a loop. First, we will run a loop from the beginning to middle of the string. Then first character will be compared with last, then second with second last, and this way up to middle of the string. If any mismatch occurs, we will not have to check it further. Just we can declare it is not a palindrome. If up to the middle no mismatch occurs, then we can finally return the true. Yes, it is a palindrome. Now it is your turn, Vidya. I am preparing you because in the sixth semester, the interview company will start to come. Your parents are also there. So in which way you are preparing, you are participating, just for your parents' satisfaction, you will have to say something. But yes, I am participating in the class. Sir has asked my name and this question. For that satisfaction level also, because the parents are also one of the stakeholder. Vidya, you are not taking that? Wish to try?
I don't understand.
Please try. Describe the logic to check whether a string is palindrome or not. Okay, I will give chance to other. Ishita Srivastav. Pragya Pandey. You are listening me, Pragya? Your mic is on? They may say that my mic is not working. Anyway, okay. Now, Yashas, you have already done the good morning. First, you have only joined alphabetically last name, but joined first. Yashas. You are there, Yashas. Prakash K.
Yes, sir.
Who is answering?
Prakash, sir.
Prakash, describe the logic to check a string whether it is palindrome or not.
This logic itself or another one, sir?
In which way you want to? You will have to debate, you will have to defend your logic. My logic is better.
No, sir, this one is better. Sir.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, first we find the length of the string.
Yes, continue.
Then in the while loop, we'll iterate the while loop till the half of the length of the string.
Okay.
We compare the first character with the last character, and then second character with the second last till we reach the middle of the string. And in case we find that either the first and last strings are not equal, we'll return false.
And there is no need to check it further.
Yeah, yes, sir. And
at that time also that it is not a palindrome. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, yes. Good, Prakash. Fine. Neeraj Sanjay? Nitish Hegde?
Yes, sir.
Who is responding?
Neeraj.
Neeraj, next time coming. Okay, so that keep your participation, that is only. So now we will see that this recursion, I have not taken recursion, we will take, I think, in the next class, but if the time will permit, because I have planned for this up to default and keyword arguments only. Okay, so this default and keyword arguments. So the functions will have the arguments. The function may or may not have the arguments. Arguments are separated by comma. So what you are calling the function and passing the parameters, those arguments will be received in the function in that sequence. I repeat, you are passing the parameter from the calling function. That parameters will be received in the called function in the same sequence. But here in Python, one gives the chance, okay, the keyword argument or this actual, better to learn from that concept only, that this all the formal argument and actual argument. So the function is having the three arguments, but one of the argument has directly in the function definition only that keyword name equal to value. Means if you are not passing that argument, that value will work. I repeat, if the function is having the three arguments and you are passing only the two arguments, for the third argument, that value will work. You have already given in the function definition. So those values we will be calling default values. And we can call also, as we have learned, the formal arguments. Straightforward, the actual arguments will be replacing the formal arguments. If you are not sending the actual arguments, that formal arguments with the default values will work. So default and keyword arguments. So default values indicate that the function argument will take that value if no argument value is passed during the function call. And in which way it is written, that your keyword name equal to value. Keyword arguments are often used for optional parameters. For example, the print function has the optional parameters int and sep. The optional parameter, if you are not giving there, that automatically it will go to the next line. If you are writing int double equal to simple one character space, then what should be printed at the end of this argument? So you can, by default, it will go to the next line. So in Python, passing keyword argument, order of argument is not important. Only the first argument should be at its correct place. Second and third you can assign, because if you have taken the function having the function name to calculate the interest, so you have given the principal rate, principal years means time, and interest rate. Interest rate is changing. I think the half yearly bank may change. So interest rate, because the real life application also you will have to learn. So interest rate you can give as there the formal argument. So if interest rate is not coming, the default interest 9% will be computed. No, bank has reduced the rate. Now they are giving only the 6%. So now the 6% I am calling the function by passing the rate also. So at that time, if you are passing 6, then the 9 will be replaced by 6%. Okay. So finally, one value for one parameter will have to give. It is not like that rate you are giving 9,6. No. For one parameter, only one value. One thing again, I want to repeat, the order of argument is not important, but the first argument should be the actual argument. And the rest of the arguments, you can change the sequence by their keywords and value. The example will clarify again and again. I will come back here. So I have given here one example taken from the book. The define first, only names are changed. So define name, function name is name. First name, last name, and I have given the default value Singh. Last name having the default value Singh. And section 5B, the section parameter also having the default value 5B. And herein I am printing just one statement within that function, first name comma last name, and one string studies in section. So if I am calling the function only by passing the name Priyanka, so first name will be replaced by Priyanka, You have not given the second and third positional parameters. What a time. In Unix, we are also calling it positional parameters. Okay. So that second and third argument you have not given. So what the default value it will take? Last name Singh and section 5B. Priyanka Singh studies in 5B. Now you are passing the two arguments or arguments directly. What will go to the first name? What will go to the last name? Ronak Suryavansi. So yes, Ronak will replace, not replace, not to say. Ronak is the first name and the Suryavansi is the last name. And this section 5B is the default value argument. Okay. So Ronak Suryavansi studies in 5B. Now I'm giving all the three arguments. Sharmila, Raghav, 5C. So Sharmila will go for the first name. Raghav will go for the last name. And this 5C will replace the value this 5B. For that, always I am telling straightforward, the actual argument will replace the formal argument. If you are passing a value, then this value will go 5C here. If you are not passing, then 5 will work for. So Sharmila Raghav 5C. So now it will display Sharmila Raghav studies in 5C. Now see that if order is not important, then I have rudely typed. Okay, first I will write here calling the function section equal to 7B and Abhishek. Then what? Then it is giving error. Positional argument follows keyword argument. What a statement to remember for the online exam also. Positional argument follows the keyword argument. Okay. So first keyword argument should be there. After that, you cannot have the sequence. So I'm writing here name equal to Abhishek and section equal to 7B. I'm not giving for the last name. And I'm not giving that section B here, the third argument. So you are giving here directly keyword argument, section equal to 7B. The 7 will be replacing the 5B. And finally, it is displaying Abhishek Singh studies in 7B. Marin Jacob, you have understood? My mentee Ramya has joined. Ramya today. Ajahn Sarani has joined. Nikhil P. Nikhil Mishra has joined. So I will have to check the chat box, then only that. Okay, finally, Manpreet has joined. Lastly, Shiar, Isha.
Yes, sir, I was the...
Who is your name?
Sir, Manpreet, sir.
Manpreet. Again, Thami Manpreet.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Yes, sir.
Ji? Changa hai ji.
Sir, sab changa, sir.
Okay, okay, okay. Oh, namaste to your parents.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Manpreet, you are getting it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In the review question, I will take you that question at that time. One more. Okay. I have directly taken in this Python, IPython, where you are getting no. So from directly coded, and what we are calling the calc interest is the function name. So calc interest is the function name and it is having, yes, it is having the three arguments, PTR, principal time rate of interest. And yes, it is returning the interest P multiplied by T multiplied by R divided by 100. So I am passing here only 10,005. So 10,000 will go to the principal amount, not principal amount. And 5 will go to the time, and by default rate will be taken the 9%. For this default argument, rate will work. Comment is written. Print calculate interest, I'm passing all the three arguments. So 5 will go for a time, 10,000 for principal amount, and 7 will replace the rate of interest. The actual argument will replace the default rate. Now, I am writing here T equal to 5 and P equal to 9,000. So here, see that keyword argument may not be in the sequence. So T directly, I am giving here 5 and P 9,000. And output we are getting for all those things. So it is 5-1-ac, not 5-1-ac series. It is not 5-1-ac series. Sorry. It is default and actual argument. Default and actual argument. Because I will have to upload this slide, no? The next slide will come for that. I won't actually say these. So this is one more example directly done in IPython. And here, the Fibonacci series again encouraging the leisure for 2 minutes. Time is there. So anyone will repeat that? What was the Fibonacci problem first? Then you are giving the solution, no? You know the problem, Manpreet? You know about
problem, sir?
Fibonacci series problem. You know that history of that problem? Mehul Sakaria, you know, Mehul Sakaria, Isha Malni, you know the history of the problem? Okay, you know that who was Fibonacci? Somebody say the Fibonacci also, I am telling Fibonacci. Okay, what is the pronunciation in calling the name? The Rajendra or Rajendra. Hello? Manpreet, you know the history of Fibonacci series?
No, sir.
Nobody. Okay. So I'm taking time. The Fibonacci was establishing himself as a great mathematician. Like when you are going to visit your Muhalla city village, so some of the gray-haired, the old person will come to you that, hey, you are engineering a student, you come to me, answer one of my questions. And they will be giving you the question, the what question you are solving in like dynamic programming question. So rate of this is this, and rate of this is this, and rate of this is this. I want have the 20 rupees, and I want that 20 kg of the items. So knapsack problem like that they will give you, that it is having the space this much. So I want directly that 20 rupees and 20 kg of the vegetables, like that. So questions, and that those questions are now becoming, we are doing solving in the dynamic programming. So Fibonacci also, and the story is that I have little bit, 5 to 10% I'm spicy and tasty in that history. So Fibonacci was a great mathematician, because great, I'm telling that other golden ratio if the time will permit this Fibonacci series, the also, taken for the golden ratio letter. So he has been asked by that old gray-haired person. It is written in his book only. So I'm giving you a problem. Then one pair of rabbit produces a pair of rabbit in one term maybe of 6 months and 1 year, I don't know. And here I will not have to debate that what is the reproduction time of a rabbit pair. So one pair of rabbit produces a pair of rabbit, yes, obviously of opposite sex, in one term. The newborn pair, you try to understand in the intellectual language, the newborn pair will be fertile again, taking one term, because they are not able just to reproduce, no, just taking birth. So they will be able to reproduce. They will be fertile again, taking one term more. So next time also only one pair will be taking birth. So what will be the number of pairs after 20 years? One pair of rabbit produces a pair of rabbit, one pair of rabbit in one term. The newborn pair will take one term time to reproduce. They will be fertile again to reproduce. And if no pair dies, always they are producing that pair of opposite sex. So what will be number of pairs after 20 terms? So the Fibonacci has taken time. The old man has asked this question. And so he has generated, okay, first time one, second time also one. So okay, now this time, who has taken the birth first now? So he will be also, he or she, both will be reproducing also this. So okay, two, then one and two, three, and then two and three, five. And then 3 and 5, 8, and he has given a sequence. So the, okay, you can add this way, it is the Fibonacci series. that the current number is the sum of last two digits. So 011, 112, 123, 235, 358, and 5813, 81321, like that. So, and the number is known as Fibonacci series. And this number is also led to the research papers. And for all the sculptures, all the buildings and others, this golden ratio. Anyone can take that one flip class for that. I will give you the material for golden ratio. So, okay, that one FIBO function has been defined. N is the range. N is the range. Here, see that I am telling the range. It is not like that, that how many numbers of Fibonacci series. So here I am writing the inline comment. N is the range. Sorry. So Fibonacci series is to be displayed up to what number? What is the range you want to display? So N is the range. And in Python, it is permitted, you know that, no? By the sequence of variable names can be assigned the sequence of values. A comma B equal to 0, 1. So first two values are assigned. And while A is less than N, because I'm going to print the value of A only and end in the same line. And again, AB equal to B comma A plus B. So the value of B will go to A and value of A plus B will go to B. And this value will be printed and printed and printed up to the value of A is less than N. So here I have given the output inter-range for Fibonacci series 1 lakh, and it is printing up to 1 lakh. After deciding these two numbers, it will be greater than 1 lakh. So it, the range is given 1 lakh, so it is printing. If the question is given to print 20 terms, so then you will have to see that first you print these two and rest of the 18 you print here in this loop. I repeat, 20 terms of Fibonacci series or range. So terms if it had given, so first you print these two, first two, 0 and 1, and then I am not used here that display the Fibonacci series using recursion. It is simple function we are touching today. Now it is the time for the review question. One by one, either everyone you will have to write in the chat box if your mic is not working, if I am calling your name. If your mic is working, that is also being recorded, and you will have to answer that question. So I am first coming to that meeting, so that will be only visible to the screen. And if you have taken care of the class, Toshiki Kamana, either in the chat box or unmute your mic and answer my question. Kaushiki Kamana. What to do now? If you are not responding by chat box, not responding to unmuting the mic, so means just you have joined the class and left that, or physically you have moved to the for the other one. For that, I will have to mark you absent. Kaushiki is not answering. Okay, Khagendra. Kaushiki, yes, sir. Khagendra also. Kaushiki. I want to print one random integer from 2 to 5. Write in the chat box. First import random, what you will write? Any random number from 2 to 5. Next, Khagendra, unmute your mic and say the answer or write in the chat box. What do you mean by keyword argument? Khagendra, first you talk to me, Khagendra, it should be Khagendra. Khagendra represents your Garuda or Jatayu.
Yes, sir.
Khagendra, you know the meaning of...
Hello, sir.
Khagendra, you know the meaning, sir, of name.
Hello, sir.
Khagendra, you know the meaning of your name?
Yes, sir. Some Garuda.
Garuda. Okay, fine. So, okay. So, we are also that in Hindu mythology, Garuda. Okay, fine. Khagendra, you will have to define, unmuting your mic, what do you mean by keyword argument? 1 minute question. You can take 1 minute, but time is already 12:19, I think. So one previous classroom assignment was given where, so it is time, anyone can come forward, so that today my flip class is there, what the assignment, what the classroom assignment you have given, I want to produce again, I have some other findings, I'm going to solve this problem or these two, three topics, and one class can be given as the flip class to three of the students. Okay, because the time is not there, I don't want to make the class lengthier. So first stopping the sharing. And then, okay, Isha Malnir has given. Good, Isha Malnir. So now it is the time, if you have already given the attendance, you just give the, your USN attendance fast. So that will be recorded. And then I will making the recording off. Gangawa, Nitin, Suraj, Manpreet, Nag Mohan, Karan, Sekhar, Mohammed, Aman Khan, Mehul, Ishita Chattopadhyay, I am not finding the Ishita Srivastav, Onkar Patra, I am not passing the Ishita is not there. Ishita.
Yes, sir.
Met the attendance?
Sir, yes. I am Ishita Chattopadhyay.
I am asking Ishita Srivastav. She is
so
not
she
there.
Is not well. She told me that she is not well, so she might not attend the class for today.
Why she told you?
Sir, she called me today in the morning.
I asked this question, no. She can call me also, no?
Yeah.
So that
I'll tell her to inform.
Yes, you message her. So that Sarva is asking, she should tell me. I have told so many times. Having your word, I will give you attendance. There may be so many reasons. The best reason may be there. My not in my area. I couldn't join your class. Give me attendance. I have told that I will give you attendance. I do not care for attendance. I care for attention only.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You just tell me, sir, I am not able to join the class. I am having the different assignment. Okay. You will get the attendance, you can leave that room. Okay, and my pitch of sound, Ishita, so that I am creating some havoc by my pitch of sound. Nothing like that, no?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. So Nitin N also I am seeing at last. Nitin N should join earlier, being this year. All you have marked the attendance, now making the recording off. Anyone left? Your attendance is already witnessing, marked in your, because the recording is there. No, anytime I can see the recording, so that how many students we are present today. Nitin N, Neeraj, Sanjay, Nitish Hegde. One more name I'm calling that. Sai Nikita Varna. Shai Nikita Varna, Pratik Bhaduka.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Yes. Pratik Day is also there. Good.
Excuse me, okay. Sir.
Yes, please go ahead, Shai Nikita.
You called my name?
Yes, I have called your name only. At yes, first, with Marin Jacob, I have called your name.
Okay, yes. Sir.
You know me, no, from first year, Shai Nikita?
No, sir. Oh, from second year.
Then who Nikita is knowing from the first year?
Nikita S. Varna.
She is not there today.
I don't know, sir.
S. Varna. See that. I was thinking that the Sai Nikita is better than Nikita S. Varna. But Nikita S. Varna was better. I don't know how much marks we have given. Meera Krishna.
Yes, sir.
Meera, how are you, Meera? When you have
fine, sir. Sorry, sir.
When you have joined the class today?
At 11:25.
11:35. Okay.
7:25.
No problem. 7:35.
11:25.
11:25. Yeah. Okay, fine. You have made your attendance. Everybody has made the attendance. Ajahn Sirani is still not there. Vishnu Vardhan is not there. Hemant. Some Hemant. Some other madam has told that one Hemant is there. CR Isha Malnir. Isha?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know that Hemant is not coming to the class?
No, sir.
Okay. Hemant, Ajahn, Ishita, and Vishnu Vardhan. Yes, Isha, you want to say something?
Sir, Vishnu Vardhan was there.
Vishnu Vardhan? No. Today we have seen the Vishnu Vardhan. You have marked the attendance, you have checked, you are calling that, okay, present I mark it, no problem. Okay, take care. I love you all. I'm quitting now. Stopping.
Thank you, sir.
Stop recording.